His praise from the ends of the earth. Ye that go down to the sea. All that is there with me. The isles. Lift up their voice. Let the inhabitants of the rocks sing. Let them shout from the mountains. Let them give glory to the Lord. Sister Winifred, Rodney. We draped the seat where she sat. And because of her contribution to this congregation, to this community, she was a member serving in in health and wellness. So if you would come. Thank you. Celebrate her life. As John Carlton said last night, it's a time for celebration. She would want us to celebrate her life, her legacy, all that she has done from Jamaica to New York and now to Atlanta. And now she is in heaven with the Lord she had prepared to meet. Amen, somebody? This is a church service. Amen? It celebrates the life of Sister Rodney. Mother Rodney, we draped her seat where she sat on Sunday mornings. And because of what she did in this church, which is her health and wellness jacket, being a nurse in this church, we honor her and we honor this family. And those of you who are here, please, you're here to help this family get through this time. It's not easy. We know that. Many of us have been through that when we've lost parents. But it's you that will engage in the service to help them to lift their spirits, to help them to sing, to help them to praise the Lord. Amen? What a wonderful life that we are here to celebrate. A legacy, a lasting legacy that she has left with us. Of all the wonderful things she has done, not just in her family, but wherever she went, how she put smiles on people's faces. So we're here today to celebrate Sister Winifred Rodney. Let's pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you for this day. When it's hard, you help us. You told us to cast all our cares on you because you care for us. I bring the Rodney family, Lord. We come to celebrate the life, the legacy, the honor of Sister Rodney, affectionately called Winnie, Lord. But God, we celebrate and we say thank you for 78 years of life. The 78 years you've been good. Through the ups and the downs, you are a good God. And Father, we're here to praise you and to glorify you for her name, for who she was. Glorify you, O God, for all that you accomplished in her life and through her life. For the many lives that we know that she touched and the lives we do not know that she touched. God, you left her. You had a plan for her and you lived out your plan through her. So, God, we say thank you for her life, for her being a child of her mother and father, for her being a wife of Brother Conrad. Father, we just pray today that you bless the children, the grandchildren, the nieces, the cousins, the aunts, uncles, all over this country, wherever they may be, in England, in Canada, and Jamaica. Wherever they are, God, be with them in the name of Jesus. Father, you're the one that told us, blessed are they who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Send your comforting angels and spirit with us now. In the name of Jesus, we can give you praise. Amen, and amen, and amen. Minister Cece is going to come and give us a selection. Would you please join her? You can clap your hands in the church. Amen. Join her in the singing.
Thank you.
praising my Savior all the day long. We are still here to worship and to praise God. I can just see her sitting there and worshiping God, raising her hand sometimes, and she has that little sway when she's enjoying the music. So she is praising her Savior. Amen? Scripture reading this afternoon, Old Testament, by one of the deacons in our church, the chair of the deacons, Deacon Dave Marshall. New Testament reading will be Carissa Josephat, a granddaughter. Immediately following that, we will have a solo by Sister Melissa Rodney. So would you please give ear as the word is read, followed by a song.
Considering that the righteous is taken away from the evil to come. He shall enter into peace. They shall rest in their beds, each one walking in his uprightness. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you.
Say something. Last night when we were at the funeral home, many people got up and spoke. We are grateful for their words of encouragement, the words of just telling us, reminding us what a wonderful, wonderful person. At the funeral of Abraham Lincoln, one of the senators got up and made this comment. He said, "You know how Lincoln loved to cut down trees." He said, "But today, a tree has fallen. It's hard to scale or measure a tree when it's up. It's easier to scale and to measure and hear the breadth and the width of what Sister Winifred meant to us." Reflections will tell us some things we did not know, because the tree, a majestic tree, is now laying on its side, and we get to be aware of the length of it. Amen? They're going to play a video tribute. Would you listen carefully?
My eyes are red raw from crying. It seemed but unbelievable I'll never hear your voice again and see that beautiful smile. He wasn't just my sister. He was my friend. Don't say my best friend. I sometimes guess you think I was crazy. You probably said out aloud, "Dawg, it's crazy." Then you laughed. I never got the chance to come to America to be with you due to COVID. I so much want to hug you and kiss your lovely cheek. And you're still smiling. I can see you. Yes, I can feel you. I'm happy you've got no more pain. And it's wonderful. I'm really surely going to miss you. My eyes are red raw from crying. It seemed but unbelievable I'll never hear your voice again and see that beautiful smile. It wasn't just my sister. You was my friend. outside my best friend. And sometimes I guess you think I was crazy. You probably said that aloud, Tony is crazy. And you laughed. I never got the chance to come to America to be with you due to COVID. I so much want to hug you and kiss your lovely cheek. And you're still smiling. I can see you. Yes, I can feel you. I'm happy you've got no more pain. And it's wonderful. I'm really surely going to miss you. And I'm going to miss your chat to the phone. You FaceTiming me and staring at me. And I say, what are you looking at? Then you shake your head. And we'd start laughing. And I'd make you start sweating with my intimate story about myself. Winnie, I never got to say goodbye. But in Whitney Houston's song, I will always love you. This poem, short poem, is about you. Winnie, your sisters Maureen and Pauline love you. What we will always remember most about you is your smile, sense of humor, and above all, your love of family, especially your children and grandchildren. They were your pride and joy. Every accomplishment and milestone they achieved was a great source of joy and happiness for you. Dear sister Winnie, Pauline and I are deeply sorry we are not able to say goodbye to you. We love you. We miss you. You will be in our hearts forever. Love you always from your sisters, Maureen and Pauline. Rest in peace, my dear sister.
What is lovely never die. The flesh may be gone, but the spirit live on. Your precious, lovely memory, that beautiful smile will always be in my heart for a heaven. Love you, Winnie.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Pauline Campbell. Winnie and I became friends from a young age. As the years passed, we remained friends and actually became very good friends. I used to tell my peers that we were sisters, but whenever they asked Winnie if she was my sister, she would tell them that I am her niece. We would always laugh at that idea. Winnie and I remained very close, and we would visit each other's home frequently. She absolutely loved cooking and baking, and would prepare such delicious meals. She was truly a sweet and loving person, and would go the extra mile to help those around her. Winnie was very special and will surely be missed by everyone who knew her.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Maxine Rodney. I'm here today to acknowledge my best friend and mother-in-law, Winifred Rodney. She was a wonderful and kind person. Words cannot describe. I'm going to miss her dearly. God be with her. Thank you.
I forever love you, my mother. You are one of the best moms in the world. Love you, mommy. Love you so much. I don't really want to go see you before all of this happened. But God knows best. You are in a resting place, a better place. Love you.
Grandma, not only were you a grandmother, but you were my travel partner. From daily car rides dropping you off at work with Dada to my first international trip to meet your mom in London, You showed me how to be independently curious. You were always with me, telling me who and where to visit. You walked so many streets with me via FaceTime, and it brought me so much joy to hear and see the excitement on your face. It meant so much to me to be able to host you for your last few visits to New York. It was always like a window into your past. I got to see you reconnect and reminisce with family and close friends. I know you will rest well in this Georgia soil, but I'm happy I have a memory of you right up the street from me every time I pass Sterling Place in Brooklyn. Thank you for this special gift. Enjoy your new journey. I love you, Grandma.
Good day, everyone. My condolence to the Rodney family. Well, me and my grandmother have a good relationship. The best grandmother ever. She made me know about nice things and matching things, clothes and shoes. She don't make her own, she try her best to send what she have and give us what we have. And when you call her, she'll listen to us. I'm praying for you, you know. I love you guys. Don't feel like I forget you. You're always in my prayers. I said, yes, Grandma, I know. She always tell me that she's always praying for me. And I love her and I miss her so much. And I'm very upset myself. I did not get to come to America to look for her, and I am very sad about that, and I will always remember her. I'll always remember, I love her so much. She will be missed by me, and I will always be in her prayers, because I know she will be in heaven watching over us, looking down and guiding us.
We are grateful for those reflections. I'm sure many of you will recall those voices, recall the things that they were helping us to recall and remember. As I said earlier, many of us, we wish we had something wonderful where we could stand and say something. But because our time is limited today, because of what's happening with this pandemic, we want to make sure that everyone is safe. But would you look at your neighbor and say, I loved Winnie. They can't see your smile, but please let your smile be in your eyes. Say it again. Say, we loved Winnie. Didn't we love her? Somebody with joy in their hearts, and somebody who walks with God, say this with me. Thank God he sent Winnie to this world. Yeah, say it out loud one more time. Thank God he sent Winnie to this world. Come on, give God a hand clap. That exercise meant that we loved Sister Rodney for me, for you, Winnie, for you, Mother, Aunt, Grandma. We are thankful to God for allowing her to come. So when you go home, all of you are now able to say, I said something at Sister Rodney's or Mother Winnie's celebration service. You can all say, I had something to say. Amen? At this time, her son, Donovan, is going to come and share. If there are no others, I'm looking at the family.
to be done. My mom, Winifred Rodney, born August 28, 1942. Her date of registration was December 2nd, 1942. On her date of death is December 8, 2020 at 12:45 a.m. My mom met and has been in love with my dad since she was 17 years of age. My mom has now gone ahead to be with her Lord and Savior at the age of 78 years. So if you all do the math, she has been with my dad for 61 years. My mom has been the matriarch of the family. She's a sweet and loving spirit that knows to call on the name of Jesus. She knew the name was the sweetest name, name above all names, her wonderful Savior. My mom was a great listener, an encourager to everyone that she comes in contact with. She would encourage her family members through good and bad times. And when listening, if she hears something that was not right, my mom had a way of expressing herself. Most of you would have heard it. She would just simply say, But after that comes her word of wisdom and encouragement. My mom played a role or played a part in almost all our family members, immediate family, distant family. She was always willing to help and extend her home to those who were going through some transitional issue. This happened so often that sometimes as kids, our kids, our immediate kids, would feel displaced because we would have to either share a room with some visitor or give up our room to a visitor. But my mom was willing and always willing to help those that were in need. Her favorite scripture was Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And I believe she led with that scripture to ensure her kids, her grandkids, or anyone who came to her for anything were never in want. And she would provide what she can to give to anyone who approached her for anything. And with that said, that she led with, I shall not be in want. My mom knew how to throw down a feast and feed folks with some finger-licking food. And I'm not talking about KFC. She never liked the idea of seeing folks without. And so if anybody would turn up at her home at dinner, she would surely offer them a little of what we have. affectionately called Nene by my dad in his earlier days. She affectionately also was called Big Mommy by almost everyone in the family. At times, some would say Winnie, but my aunt, Auntie Jean, would surely get the kids for saying Winnie. She never believed that as kids we should be calling our mother Winnie.
That's right.
That was reserved for the adults my mom's age. Big Mommy, Nene, Winnie, Sister Rodney, Mother Rodney, whoever you affectionately knew her, keep that sweet, peaceful memory of her in your hearts until we all meet with her in heaven. So folks, I adhere us to live Christ-like life so she will see us again in heaven.
Amen.
Thank you all.
Celebration is winding down to a close. I want you to know that I stand here as I've always honored her and called her Sister Rodney. Your dad, Conrad, I'll recall Brother Rodney. Loving your mother. And I consider to be able to stand here a majestic honor. It is with a two-edged sword that pastors have the honor to pastor and sheep. Scripture tells us to diligently know our sheep. And so through this, I'm honored, and I thank you. We will have her selection. She's going to come. Aunt Jean,
yes.
Will you please come and sing our selection for us?
And we are
the church says, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Sister Sheila James. Again, it is my honor to be able to stand and say a few last words. I won't take long. I'd like to tell you a story of how I knew that I was her pastor. There are different things in the lives of people in our church that happen that when you know that switch has been flipped. A few years ago, I was preaching and then the service ended. And as was her custom, she always met me and Brother Rodney. They would be kind of last to linger and to talk to people. People wanted to get to your mother and grandmother and shake their hands, and then she would make her way outside. And one this Sunday, she was going outside. She stopped and said, "Pastor, I want to tell you that my brother died in England." I said, "Oh, Sister Rodney, I'm so sorry to hear that." She said, "Yes, I would love to be there. It hurts so bad. I would love to be there, but unfortunately, I can't." I said, "I know. I wish I could be there with you, and we could go together. We pray and support you." She said, "Oh, okay. Well, I want you to know, and we'll be praying. The service is tomorrow." I said, "Okay." I said to her, "When you need me, call me." She says, "Okay." She and Brother Rodney walked out the door. The next morning, 4:30 a.m., I get a call. And it's Sister Rodney, and she's saying to me, "They're on the line, and I'm listening to the service, and I want you to be with me to listen as well." 4:30 in the morning, 5 o'clock, somewhere in there, she calls and says, "I want you to be with me to hear the service." I felt such an honor that she felt the freedom to call, to say, "I want you to be with me on this while I'm listening to the service." I knew that day that she had accepted me for who I was. Thank you, Sister Rodney, for the great things you have done. As I reflected upon her life, I wanted to find a poem that I hope will inspire you and help you. Listen to the poem. The author is unknown, but I believe it reflects a lot of what we have heard. "Your mother is always with you. She's the whisper of the leaves as you walk down the street. She's the smell of certain foods that you eat, flowers that you pick. She's the fragrance of life itself. She's the cool hand that touched your forehead when you were not feeling well. She's the breath in the air, especially in the winter's air that we breathe. She's the sound of rain that lulls us to sleep. We remember her, oh so sweet. Your mother lives inside all of you, inside your laughter, inside your memories. She's the place you came from. She was your first home. She was your first friend. She'll be with you every step that you take." But remember this: nothing can separate you from your mother. Not time, not space, and not even death itself. For she is always with you." Amen.
Amen.
2 Corinthians chapter 5, 2 Corinthians chapter 5. I'll begin reading at verse 1. I'm going to read through verse 8, say a few things, and then we will go. The Apostle Paul is writing. And he writes concerning us, those who are Christians, those who love the Lord. Listen to his words. And I'm reading from the New Living Translation. For we know that when this earthly tent we live in is taken down, that is, when we die and leave this earthly body, we have a house in heaven, an eternal body made for us by God, and not by human hands. We grow weary in our present bodies, and we long to put our heavenly bodies like new clothes on. For we will put on heavenly bodies. We will not be spirits without bodies. While we live in these earthly bodies, we groan and sigh. But it is not that we want to die and get rid of these bodies that clothe us. Rather, we want to put on our new bodies so that these dying bodies will be swallowed up by life. God himself has prepared for us that a guarantee he has given us by his Holy Spirit. So we are confident, even though we know that as long as we live in these bodies, we are not at home with the Lord. For we live by believing and not by seeing. Most of you will recall that as we live by faith and not by sight, as the New King James says. And lastly, verse 8, yes, we are fully confident, and when we would rather be away from these earthly bodies, for then we will be at home with the Lord. Amen. I want to talk to you for just a few moments about she's moved to her new home. Paul describes for us and tells us that these bodies are temporary tents. Many of you have experienced tents. We use them for camping out. We use them for shelter, temporary shelter. But tents are not made as permanent structures. Tents don't last long. They are made to be portable, movable. Tents are made from different materials than permanent structures like blocks or bricks. Tents are made from cloth, some substance that allows it to decay over time. Many of you good Bible students will remember that Paul was an itinerant tent maker. He was bivocational at times, and his other job was to make tents at times to sustain himself. So Paul describes tents in this passage of when we leave this earth, or when we are here on this earth, our bodies are like tents. They are not permanent structures. They're not here to last forever. Amen, somebody. They're not here to last for immortality forever. They are here as temporary to hold or house our spirit that the Lord gives us. I want to tell you this afternoon, brothers and sisters, that Sister Winifred Rodney knew that her tent, that her body that the Lord had given her was a temporary structure. She understood that one day she would have to leave this earth. And she knew, and she had read, I believe, John chapter 14, where it says that Jesus has gone away to prepare a place for us. And brothers and sisters, I'm so confident this morning that Sister Winnie, Sister Rodney knew her Savior. And she understood that I'm only here for a little while. Some 78 years I'm here to live out the plan that God has laid for me. Amen, somebody. This is a service. where we talk back and forth, where we are celebrating and celebrating. But Sister Rodney understood that this body is temporary. The Bible says that it groans from time to time. It can't get comfortable from time to time. It sometimes longs to not be here, but to be on the other side. Y'all ain't with me. Sometimes when we go through trials and when we go through troubles, we have to say to ourselves, I don't want to be here anymore. I just want to be like the psalmist says, if I had birds of a wing, if feathers of wings of a bird, I would fly away. How many of you have experienced that through your life sometimes? That trials get so hard, trials get so complex, the burdens and the things that we go through, if we had wings like a bird, we would fly. I believe Sister Rodney understood that. That these bodies, all of our bodies, one day, are going to be required. All of us will be required. Let me say it again. All of us have been designed by God to not live in these temples of flesh, these tents forever. And that one day he's coming back. Yes. Amen, somebody. Amen. Just two Tuesdays ago, he came back. Yes. Shook his child and said, wake up, daughter. That which you've been praying for is here, and it's time to take off this earthly tent. Now, I know some of you and some of us and even myself, I'm going to miss Sister Rodney. But let me just give you the word of hope, that her word is to us that no longer am I here. I know that you feel like I'm not here, but as I read to you the poem, I'm always with you. It seems like a paradox almost, doesn't it? That when Jesus says, I will never leave you, nor will I ever forsake you, but I am with you until the ends of the earth. He was not here physically, but he said, I'll be with you always. Yeah. Amen, somebody. Yeah. Can't you just hear Sister Winnie's voice, Sister Rodney's voice, Mama's voice, Grandmama's voice telling us, don't worry, I've been called home. Because I lived a life that I can now go and be with the Savior who took away this tent. Let me give you three quick things or four quick things about tents. Tents are temporary. They're not made to last forever. They are temporary. They're designed to be temporary. In them we groan. We be anxious. Lord, one day I'm going to leave this place. Because I know that my body, and we saw how Sister Rodney, over time, her body was beginning to give out. She was tired. She knew her body was temporary. But she made sure that even though her body is temporary, but her spirit would live on forever. Paul says it's the down payment. It's that something that we feel inside. When everything is going bad, something that cannot be explained, that Jesus is on the inside of her. When we don't understand everything, we don't want things to happen, I believe Sister Rodney had a down payment of the Holy Spirit that said, I'm with you, daughter, through the thick and through the thin. Amen, amen somebody? Amen. It's a temporary, the tent, this body, this flesh, is temporary. She understood that. Number two, the tent that Sister Rodney wore was for traveling. Amen. What I've heard you last night in talking about it, even when I found out more about her life over the last 12 or 13 years she's been here, your mother, Sister Winnie, was a trailblazer. A woman full of courage. A woman who had distinctive courage and faith to follow where she believed the Lord was leading her. She left Jamaica and moved to New York. Y'all ain't with me. The Bible says we walk by faith and not by sight. She had a foundation that believed that this tent, no matter where I go, the Lord would be with me. Thy rod and thy staff, it would comfort me. So she had courage to believe that if I leave Jamaica and move to New York, that the Lord would be with her. Amen, somebody. She believed in traveling, and then She was so bold to say, okay, I'm done with New York. Let's go to Atlanta. Followed one of her daughters down here. She was absolutely a trailblazer, a person who had great courage and great faith.
Yeah, yeah.
She laid the road for you.
Amen.
Where she went, as I heard Donovan and others say, when she came from Jamaica, many people followed.
Amen.
When she left New York, many people followed. She traveled. The tent at times would be folded up and moved to different locations because she knew the Lord would be with her. A tent is for covering, not a permanent structure. It's for temporary covering from the elements of the world. I submit to you, brothers and sisters, that your mother, your grandmother, she had the sense that if I can't be with them, I'm going to cover them in prayer.
Amen.
I wish I had a church that would pray with me.
Amen.
Last night I heard many of you say, my mother prayed for me.
Yeah.
Didn't that sound like a song?
Amen.
Had me on her mind.
Yeah.
Took the time and prayed for me.
Yeah.
Aren't you glad that Sister Winnie prayed for you?
Amen.
Sister Rodney prayed for you? It was her act of covering. It was her gift of mercy. It was what God had given her that even though sometimes she couldn't get to you, she was going to pray for you.
Yeah.
I believe what Michelle said last night is that she would call each person by name.
Yeah.
Don't rush me through my prayer. Let me call your name before the throne of grace. Somebody ought to say amen to that. That she didn't allow somebody just to feel like, oh, you just want it. She said, I'm going to call your name before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords because you mean that much to me. I'm going to call your name and don't rush her through it. She was a gifted at making sure that the structure covered. She covered her family. She watched over them. She trained as she covered. They told me last night that all the boys had to be sure to be able to cook. The girls too. But Michelle said she learned how to cook lasagna. I don't know about y'all, but I don't think lasagna is a Jamaican food. Married for 61 years. Covering. Watching over, praying for, loving, caring, devoted to Brother Rodney, Brother Conrad. She watched over you, made sure that everything, she was a covering. That tent was not just selfishly exposed for herself, but she made sure that her tent was always expanding, taking people in, covering them and praying for them. Her gift of compassion and her gift of giving always allowed the tent to be expanded. If you learn something from your mother, don't be closed, but learn to be a giver.
Yeah.
Learn to keep on giving.
Yeah.
When it's good, give.
Yeah.
When it's hard, give.
Yeah.
They said last night, and I heard over time, that she even made these wonderful big meals. That no matter how much she had prepared, she always believed there was going to be some left over, invited people to take some home with you.
Amen.
Can I get an amen in the house?
Amen.
She wanted to make sure that the giving, her nature of giving would always be a legacy. Her compassion would always be a legacy of how you remember her, that she was a great giver and a great server.
Amen.
And lastly, the tent at some point has to be taken down. When you read what I just read to you, the tent is not permanent. The tent is a temporary structure. Brothers and sisters, family and friends, the tent was not made to stay here. The tent was not designed to last for eternity. The tent was designed that one day it would get folded up. And in the folding, God would get the glory.
Amen.
Let me say that to you another way. That on this journey, the tent exposed to the elements gets ragged, gets torn. It groans, the Bible says, longs to be at home in heaven alone. The tent at some point has to say, I'm going to take this tent off because I know I haven't been designed to stay here a long time. 78 years, God has been gracious. But the tent was in pain. The tent had some abnormalities. The tent that she was in was not always able to have the mobility and to walk around like she wanted to, or to cook like she wanted to. The tent was tired. And the tent said, Lord, I believe. I talked to all my children. I'm through. On a Monday afternoon, I talked to my children, and I talked to my grandchildren. I talked to everybody that I could sense I needed to talk to. Because the tent was being folded up. Y'all ain't with me.
Yes, yes.
The grace of God allowed all of y'all to call and to talk to her. And you called and talked to her. The grace of God was allowing you to see that God is good even in the midst of folding up the tent. The tent sensed that it was ready to go home. The tent sensed my time is short. The text says that God is on his way. So God, give me the grace to be able to speak to my children and let them know that I love them. Somebody said last night, she told them over and over, I love you. I love you. Can't you hear that ringing out in her voice? I love you. I care about you. But if you're going to honor the tent, you're going to honor your mother and your grandmother, please, as she did, to prepare you to go to move from Jamaica to New York and to New York to Atlanta. As she paved the way with her courage and her strength, I pray today that you would honor her. Those of you who do not know Jesus, the Bible says he is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. One of them disciples said, where are you going? How can I be with you so long? And he says, well, you don't know the way. He says, I am the way. Please honor Sister Whitney on this day. Sister Rodney on this day. She always went ahead and prepared a place for you. She's doing the same today. She's run on ahead, Brother Rodney. She says, if you want to see me again, I'm going on to make sure everything's all right. Give your heart to Jesus. Honor her by saying, Mama, Grandmama, family, friend, whoever, I want to see you again. Thank you for being a trailblazer. Thank you for walking by faith and not by sight. That you've gone and folded up your tent to be with God. The Bible says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. She is absent from us, but she is present with the Lord. Amen, somebody? And here's the paradox. She's absent, but yet she is present. We don't understand it, but she is absent and present all at the same time. She's still talking. She's still leading. She's still trailblazing. She walked by faith and not by sight. Heads bowed, eyes closed. Father, we thank you for this day and once again allowing us to be your children. We thank you for this family. We pray for this husband. We pray for these five children. Even in the absence of Philip, God, we pray for these daughters and these sons, that you would give them the strength to face the days ahead, to be with them, Lord, to give them your comfort and the assurance of your presence and your peace. Father, we pray that you would talk to them, that you would help them, that you would encourage them, that you would steady their steps, that you would bind up their hearts, that the tears that they share today and in the days that come, Scripture tells us they that shall sow in tears shall one day reap in joy. So Father, be with us as we leave from this place. Thank you for the life of Sister Rodney. We give you praise and glory for 78 years that you allowed her to be with us. Bless us. Keep us is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. And amen. The Willie Watkins staff. The congregation, please stand.
My life for all time, Mama. Life's so many friends. just want to thank God for what he's done. Thank you. Family, may his peace.
May his peace be with you till we meet again. May his peace be
distance short.
Till we reach that distance short.
Get over there!